I'm anticipating my hiking and biking tours even more. Here is a great way to explore your tours virtually. If you like hiking or biking, you're probably making use of your smartphone or special GPS devices to find your way. And besides your own creativity, there is plenty of other sources where you can find nice proposals for your tracks. I will just briefly show three tools and sources which allow you to create, share, and download GPS tracks. Then we will learn how to import your tracks into Google Earth Pro. And then, of course, we will start a virtual flight with an example GPS track. Finally, I will explain some Google Earth Pro settings where you can adjust the camera angles, the flight speed, etc. Today, there is plenty of great tools to create hiking and biking tours. Many platforms are also offering downloads for a small subscription fee or even for free. I have just three of my favorites here. First, I'm using the good old Basecamp program from Garmin, which is freeware. It's the Mac version here, but there is also a Windows version available. For me, it still has its justification because it works offline and it allows to use official Garmin maps as well as open source maps. And it has expert features for planning. Basecamp also has an export function, which allows you to export any of your tracks. You just need to mark it and then start the export. You can choose between different formats. We want the GPX format because this is the most compatible one for common use. And by the way, I'm using this format to archive my tracks. Google Earth Pro is able to import the GPX and the KML format. Of course, Basecamp can export both formats. Just for your information, I realized that the Google Earth app and the browser version import the KML format only. Second, I'm showing Comode here, which is one of the most popular platforms to create and share tracks. It includes also a great smartphone app that helps you to find your way. There are functions to work on your tracks and to share them with your friends. On the bottom, we find a really nice feature to analyze your tours. It tells you more about the nature of your path. You can analyze the height profile and you get information about the way, which could be asphalt, gravel, etc. We also find an export function for our desired GPS format here. Third, I need to mention the Garmin Connect app, which I also use on my smartphone or via a browser on the PC, as you can see here. It plays in the professional class and it integrates perfectly Garmin devices. For me, it has the advantage that I can directly connect my smartphone with my Garmin Edge device. Since everything is stored in the cloud I have multiple options to either record, create or download my tours. It also allows to store a lot of performance and health data on top of your GPS data. This is very valuable if you want to compare and increase your physical performance. The platform is packed with features. I just want to show one example here. In case you recorded an activity, you can analyze it later over time or over distance. Nice, isn't it? We can also find an export function to download data. There is the famous GPX format to choose, or even a Google Earth format. Next, we need Google Earth Pro, which is freeware, even when the name is a bit misleading here. I'm using the Mac version here. When you start the application, you get a request to access your data. You can deny it. It has no influence on what we want to do here. Google Earth Pro has lots of nice features. For interested people, I can really recommend to play a bit further with it. But today, we only want to demonstrate a virtual flight along our GPS tracks. For that purpose, we simply go to the File menu. Then we open the folder where we stored our GPX or KML files. In my case, I'm having two examples here. I open the 60 km bike tour. And then we tick all the three boxes here, so that we get strings between the GPS points and the points will be on the ground. Then we push OK to start the import. Next, we get an overview on our whole track. Now we want to get rid of some information about each of the track points. We can do this by unticking some boxes here. We want to show the path only. Next, we can start the virtual flight along our path. And yippee yeah, we take off. We will fly automatically along our bike tour. In case this doesn't happen, you might have to adjust some settings. I will explain these in the last section of this video. Let's now fly a bit along the tour. I need to mention that in case you turned on the topography and the 3D building options in Google Earth Pro, it takes a lot of computing resources and network speed. That's why I recommend to choose the slowest flying speed to get a clear video in full resolution. You can accelerate the video later with a video viewer or a video cut program. And by the way, I recorded this video with the standard screen grabber on my Mac. I'm always excited about the good quality of these videos, where you can recognize a lot of details that are in the surrounding of your tracks. You can analyze unknown tours that you planned, and you can share this with your friends to motivate them for the next tour. In case I want to share it, I cut out the video window and I increase the speed with a video cut program later on. Video cut programs also offer some features to improve the color and the contrast according to your needs. Here is an example how it looks like with some improvements. And here is another example where we visited a place where famous chocolate is produced, and then we were riding through a nice old town. The video affects me in such a way that I immediately want to get on my bike and ride that tour. It increases my anticipation enormously, and it remains a nice memory to the tour for me. As promised, we talk now about some settings that are important. First, we check the cache memory. Bigger is always better here, but it depends, of course, on what you have available on your computer. Then we have some settings for our tours. Here we can adjust the flight speed. As said before, better choose the slowest speed. Otherwise, your network or your computer might be too slow to crunch all the data. Then you can adjust your camera angles, and at the bottom you can adjust the resolution. Just to give you an idea, the given settings make my 2015 Mac pretty busy when I start a virtual flight. In case I choose a higher speed or resolution, it cannot produce a smooth video anymore. Okay, that's it. Let's summarize. We talked about the sources for our GPS tracks that we need for the virtual flights. We learned how to import the data into Google Earth Pro and how to start a virtual flight along a GPS track. I think we saw the value that it brings to our leisure time activities, possibly also to your professional work. Finally, we checked some settings that are important if you want to successfully create a video. Hope you enjoyed this extra episode. And you know, further episodes, apart from the usual content, will follow from time to time. Now, stay tuned and don't forget to subscribe and support the channel. See you soon in the coming episodes.